place on record that the workers in question here are the Article 190 workers, which we normally refer to as the public services. Public service, they are the people in the public service. Now, normally in dealing with public service matters like this, we have what we call the tripartite body, or we have social partners that come together to deal with matters like this. And so, when you take the worker as an, or under the social partnership or the tripartite, we have the worker, we have the workers who are normally represented by the unions. Then we have the employer or the employers. Then we have the government. Now, if you look at what is happening now, the workers are not on their own. The workers do not place themselves on the payroll. Somebody will have to employ the worker. Somebody will have to place the employer's name, the employee's name on the or the worker's name on the payroll, among other things. And the, that worker is working under somebody. He must take permission to do whatever he wants to do. And so if controller, in the best and in the scheme of things, if controller wants this particular thing to be successful, controller should have first and foremost written to the various employers under Article 190, that is all the employers or the agencies employing all the public services. Letters should have gone to the employers who have employed these people to tell them that, look, this is the exercise we are carrying out. And so kindly mobilize your people, facilitate how best you can assist us get the National Identification Authority so that they will have all your workers that you have on our payroll registered. Because beginning 1st September, without it, we cannot pay them. So controller and accountant general should have engaged the employers who are under 190. When that is done, the next body to be engaged is the National Identification Authority. Because the National Identification Authority should be able to give a clear indication of the ability and the capacity they have regarding the resources that will be made available to them, that they will be able to ensure and carry out the exercise by the ending of November. And not only that, they will also require of the employer to provide them with the statistics that they have, the numbers they have on the employment register, among other things. And we also believe that the Employment and Labor Relations Minister should have also been engaged, because in Ghana, he handles all workers, among other things. But as we speak now, the Controller and Accountant General Department has left out the employers, has left out the National Identification Authority, only telling them that they are collaborating with them, but going to the extent of threatening the workers, telling them that if by the 1st of December they don't have their cards, you will have their names deleted from the payroll. The question is this: a worker has worked the month of November without his fault, and when the employer has not facilitated this thing to be done, and NIA has not come to register him. Take, for example, the workers on the islands where nobody goes there, where network is not there, among other things. How do we get them to register? And so we are telling Controller and Accountant General Department that the way they want to go about this particular thing is unacceptable. Number two, threatening workers that by the 1st of December, if they don't get their cards, they will delete their name. It is something that is unacceptable. And should they ignore our concerns and proceed, then it will certainly receive appropriate response from us. And therefore, we want them to know that we are not happy about the way they want to go. In as much as we are committed to support this particular system, the current procedure they have adopted, it is not something that we will support. And should they insist with the threats they want to, they have so far issued, we will certainly give them appropriate response.
You say appropriate response. What exactly are you talking about? What happens if by the end of November, effective December 1, accountant, what if they go ahead? What is NAT going to do?
Oh, certainly. For now, it is our hope and belief that reason what is right, but understanding that the worker did not place himself on the payroll. Somebody placed the worker there. And so we are giving them normally in the industrial relations, this is a declaration of intention or declaration of intent. We are telling them that, look, all the options are on the table. They should not push us to the wall. And if on the 1st of December comes and they proceed, we will pick the appropriate card on the table and apply it accordingly to actually match the very action that they have taken. And they should be assured that we shall respond appropriately when they get to that particular time. Should they not need our consent and proceed with their threats?
In the meantime, what is NAT doing in regards to getting all your members onto the national ID system?
Well, we are engaging them. When we saw this thing, we are bringing it to controller. What we have done first is to write to controller to draw the attention of the challenges this thing will bring. Number two, we are engaging our members and encouraging them to get it done. That is the way to go, because you need to get the stakeholders to assist. You don't go by threats. That is all that we are saying. And so if they think that the rate at which we are moving is too slow, then we need to mobilize more people. This is about mobilization. Mobilize the people to get it done. NIA can say that, look, tomorrow I'll be in Accra Metro West. All the public workers that have not done it, come around. Why not? You won't come on board and get it done. But when you issue this particular threat, how will the worker be mobilized? The worker cannot move on his own. Even the way the worker wants to move, he must ask permission. And so we are saying that the way controller is going about it, that is not the way to go. And to make the matters worse, you issue threats on top. We say it's unacceptable. Let the stakeholders come together. Let the unions be involved. Let the employers be involved. Let the NIA give us their timetable, how they want it done. And we will all get involved in mobilizing the workers to get it done. We think that is the way we should go. As for the deadline, it is the NIA. They should tell us whether they have all the resources and the materials needed, whether to get it done in December, next year, January. It is up to the National Identification Authority to tell us that, because they can only indicate this timeline based upon the resources and the capacity they have at the moment.